Hello, this is Chef John from foodwishes.com with scalloped oysters, a super decadent special occasion side dish, perfect for the holidays, or of course anytime. This is something you want to eat maybe once a year. It is so, so decadent and delicious. All right, so let me show you how to put this together. We're going to start with a couple packages of basic standard saltine crackers. All right, we're going to crush those up nice and fine in a bowl. We're going to get about 3 cups finely crushed. Once you have that, we are going to melt 1.5 sticks of butter, which is like 3/4 cup. Well, actually, it's not like 3/4 cup. It is 3/4 cup. All right, so stir that in really well. We want to make sure all the cracker crumbs are totally saturated with butter. All right, set that aside and on to the oysters. Now, these are jarred from Washington. They were out of small, which is what I prefer. So I got the medium, which were like huge. So I'm going to take my scissors, because you can't put these on a cutting board, and I'm going to give them a few snips here and there just to break them up a little bit. By the way, if you can get fresh shucked, please do. If you can't, make sure you get some nice jarred oysters from a reputable dealer. I get mine from a guy named Vinny. He sells them out of the back of a Camaro. So, you know, top notch. All right, so my oysters are ready. I'm going to take a casserole dish. You don't have to butter it because there's like a lot of butter in this already. I'm going to spread 1/3 of the breadcrumbs down on the bottom. So we're going to spread half the oysters over those crumbs as evenly as possible. I'm going to add a little bit of cayenne, because I always do, usually. Some black pepper, and just a pinch of salt. Now, oysters are briny. Saltines, like, have salt in the name. So you don't need a lot of salt. So just a pinch of salt. Another 1/3 of the crumbs go on top of that. The rest of our oysters, all right, we're going to spread those out nice and even. Poke them down a little bit. Same deal. A little bit of cayenne. A little bit of black pepper. And a pinch of salt. But on this layer, some nice fresh parsley. This dish is so rich and decadent, like I said earlier, that the parsley really helps cut that a little bit and gives it a little herbaciousness, which, you know, I'm going to be honest, I just wanted to use the word herbaceous. All right, we're going to dump on the last of the cracker crumbs, and then we're going to get a little crazy here. We're going to pour over 1 cup of heavy cream, and we're just not going to dump it. There's a certain art and science to this. Slowly drizzle it all over. A little bit on the side, a little bit in the center, cross that way, back this way. So once the cream is drizzled over, we're going to give that a little shake and the old tappa-tappa. Is it just me, or are we like tapping a lot of things lately? All right, would you tap that? I would tap that. All right, so let's tap that down. That's going to go in a 375 degree oven for, it depends. I'm going to say 40 to 45 minutes, but you're going to go by look and feel. When it's bubbling like that, and the top is browned, it's done. Now, very crucial here, please let this cool, like, almost completely. If it's bubbling and you try to serve it, it's going to be like soup. You see here in this shot, if you let it sit for 10-15 minutes, it will actually sort of come together and solidify a little bit and be more like a bread stuffing type texture. It's actually one of those dishes that's better warm than it is hot, which also makes it a great Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, whatever side dish, because you bring it to the table and you don't care if it cools off. It's actually better that way. Also, portion size. I didn't have anything to serve this with, so that's why you see it on a plate like this. You don't want to eat a whole plate of this. That pan right there will serve 12, 14 people. Everyone just gets a little scoop, 4 or 5 forkfuls. It is that rich, decadent, and delicious, okay? So if you're all worried about all that butter and cream, relax. And by the way, if you even think of using margarine in this, don't, because you just can't do this without butter. All right, so butter or don't make it. And let me tell you, that is so delicious. By the way, if you don't love oysters, do not make this. Anyway, I hope you give that a try. Scalloped oysters, super simple. All the ingredients are on the site. And as always, enjoy.